The cow who fell in the canal. Hendrika was an unhappy cow. She lived on a farm in Holland. All summer long, she ate grass. All winter long, she ate hay. All winter and all summer, she did nothing but eat. And she gave milk to Mr. Hofstra, the farmer. Mr. Hofstra thought she was a fine cow. Eat! Eat, Hendrika, he would say. The more you eat, the more creamy white milk you can give me. Hendrika loved Mr. Hofstra, so she ate more to please him. But she was unhappy. In front of the pasture was a road. Every day, Peter, the horse, came with a wagon to take Hendrika's milk to the city. In the city, the streets are made of cobblestones, he said, and the houses have staircases on their roofs. People ride on bicycles. Hendrika wanted to see the wonderful things Peter talked about. She was tired of looking at Mr. Hofstra's house, the barn, and the windmill. The windmill had four paddles. They went round and round in the wind. They made Hendrika dizzy. Behind the pasture was a narrow canal. In the summertime, a man came through the canal with a boat to take Mr. Hofstra's cheese to market. Hendrika liked the boats. She thought it would be nice to ride in a boat to market. Peter said the cheese sellers wore colored straw hats with ribbons. Hendrika thought a colored hat would taste so good. Poor, unhappy Hendrika. She just ate and ate and ate. And she grew fat, and then fatter, and then very fat. She grew so fat, she could hardly move. She grew so fat, she could hardly see. One day, she went farther and farther along the pasture. She had eyes only for the sweet grass. And before she knew it, the canal was not deep, but Hendrika was too fat to climb out. If only she could get back to the pasture. It was springtime, and there were flowers to eat. But Mr. Hofstra didn't know that Hendrika was in the canal. He was busy getting his cheese ready for market. Suddenly, Hendrika saw an old raft. Pasture went Hendrika, past the barn, past the house and the windmill, past the tulips, past the neighbor's barn, past more houses, past another barn. There was so much to see on the canal. A whole row of houses with staircased roofs passed by. And all the townspeople cried, "Look at the cow on the canal!" They laughed to see Hendrika floating along. Hendrika loved all the attention she was getting. Hendrika broke away and ran down the street. She was enjoying the city at last. Everything was so interesting, and there was so much to see. Market was just as Peter had told her it would be, and the green hat tasted just as good as she thought it would. Mr. Hofster was there, selling his cheeses too. "Hendrika," he cried, "I thought you were home eating grass, not here eating a hat. A hat is to wear." Mr. Hofstra pushed Hendrika into Peter's wagon and drove her home. After that day, Mr. Hofstra made sure that Hendrika stayed safely in the pasture. Hendrika didn't mind. Now she had so much to think about. She chewed on the grass, looking so pretty in her green straw hat.
Dadgum! Boy, I tell you what, son, I drive my tires over a mile of busted glass just to see that picture right there.